Hi, Diana here. Welcome to the studio. It's nice to have you. Today I'm doing another fold book, accordion fold book hack. And this is the 6x9. It's Strathmore paper from Joggles. I love their accordion fold books. You might remember a few weeks ago I created this one. And you'll be able to find the link for that somewhere. And what I have here is my X-Acto knife. I prefer an X-Acto. You can use scissors, but let me show you how to use an X-Acto. First of all, you want a metal ruler. This is the one I used to use, and now I have Tim Holtz, which has a metal edge here. You need a metal edge. If you're using an X-Acto, because you don't want to slice a piece of the plastic off. So it's real good to have a metal edge. So I have already made this cut. This is my third take on starting this video. So let me go to the side. And again, if you're using scissors, I would cut down the side and across. I just feel like I get a much cleaner pass with the X-Acto blade. Now I'm going to get my head in the way, I know, because I'm seeing a shadow and I want to line that ruler up as good as possible with that fold. Okay, that feels pretty good. Now, spread your fingers so that you don't get, because if you don't, if you're going along, you could get a pivot. So you want to line up your ruler and then spread those fingers out so you're not going to get that pivot. And then take a first pass, take a second pass, and that was on the fold, so it went pretty easily. And my blade is sharp too, so that helps. Okay, we got it. We're through. Okay. You don't have to get through on the first pass. Okay, so I was a little messy, but that's okay. I'm going to go over here. I'm just thinking. Okay, thought it through and definitely going to remove this last chunk. Again, making sure I'm holding the ruler. Okay, so now I have a pocket here, okay? And I'm gonna go through and I might put another pocket here. So I'll go through and do the same thing, and I'll just speed this up so you can see it again. Now that I've cut these pockets, I've also cut a notch using a circle punch. I couldn't get through both sides of the paper with the circle punch, so then we have a big pocket, a small pocket, and the back cover. I have a pile of painted paper here. I've decided to make it a bit more casual and cut strips so that they'll go like this. I just like that look. And I think I might, especially since the front cover has gotten splattered, I think I might decorate this front cover first before I do that. So let me get to that. I've swiped three colors of Distress ink across these pages, and this is the oxide inks, and I have amber, the fossilized amber, the seedless preserves on the bottom, and peacock feathers in the middle, and those colors blend beautifully together. And I'm just using a blending tool or cosmetic wedge to carry that paint or ink all through that page. And now I'm laying over a stencil. I love this particular stencil, excuse me, from Joggles. And
I'm spritzing from maybe 8-10 inches above a fine mist. It doesn't really matter. And then I will pick up the excess water, and it really gives a beautiful overall look. And it's super simple. Love it. And here's the front. There's the back again. And as it dries, it gets more vibrant, more different coloring. The stenciling shows up more. And I just love these oxides. That's two. I did a couple of different stencils with that. I'll list everything. And now I am doing the strips. And what I'm doing is I cut the strips. I think they're about 1.5 inches high, but maybe 2 inches wide. I'm laying them onto the book, increasing them a little, then taking them off and creasing them well. And then just gluing them down. I have a heavy duty sticky glue and a piece of heavy cardboard that I'm using just to push that glue around. And I'll wrap it around using the creases in the binding strip for placement. And really making sure things are nice and tight there. Got my bone folder and bone folding it real well. If there's any glue that leaks out at this point, just grab a rag. And my fingers got so sticky, I like to keep a wet rag or a bowl of water around when I'm binding, just for this reason. It gets sticky. So I'm just being careful, and you can see I wasn't totally very careful with the back. You can see the lengths are different. I didn't do much measuring today, I'm afraid to say. And that's okay, because it's, what did I call it? Casual binding. So it's fine. It sticks together. It's interesting papers. And there's my super sticky fingers. And I did decide to grab some markers and color in those areas between the strips. I would usually have done that before adding the strips, but I forgot. So there you go. I like to have those strip colored. Or you could leave everything white if you like. It depends on what kind of aesthetic that you like. And there is the book. And I'm flipping through a little bit, and you can see that there's a space there. I'm not too crazy about that. So I'm going to use a sort of a patch to put over that strip, those areas. There, just folded those pieces in half and glued them on. And that was pretty easy to do. And now I have literally dumped all my bits and pieces out. And just going through, adding this and that, just to make my new little home, journal home here, inviting and not blank. I used washi tape to bind the bottom of that first pocket closed, but then I'm going to switch over to paper strips again. The washi is fine, but I think the strips are a little sturdier. And also, I've got so much paper, and you might too. So use the strips whenever possible, and just having a really good time here. So I hope that you enjoyed this video and that it gave you some good ideas for how to hack your journal, and maybe grab one of those beautiful accordion books. The paper is so wonderful. The Joggles uses the Strathmore paper, which is 140-pound and really great for any kind of media, including watercolor. It's the watercolor paper. So, you know, as you can see there, I'm just really putting a good coat of paint on the paper strip. And anyway, you can pop around to Joggles if you're watching it on the Joggles channel, and see my blog post there today. And if you're watching it on my channel, this will all be on my blog. And I hope that you'll subscribe to both. Joggles has lots of great information on their blog. It's been a real pleasure to work with them. And that's actually a Joggles piece from a stencil of theirs. I'm just gluing bits and things in here, having a great time. So don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and the subscribe button. And I will see you very soon. I do enjoy your comments. If you have any questions, leave them below. I think Joggles are usually disabled, but you can leave the comments over on their blog, or certainly email me. I'll see you guys soon. Thanks so much for spending part of your day with me. Thank you.